I warmly welcome you to the presentation about the paper called Managing Knowledge of Intelligent Systems, the Design of a Chatbot Using Domain-Specific Languages. In this session, I'm going to speak about a CIM-funded research project in which we implement a chatbot that is based on a domain-specific language. As we want to manage this intelligent system, we are attempting to create a visualization of its knowledge transfers and enable humans to modify it. With this approach, we intend to manage its knowledge-intensive processes, generate an expectation about their outcomes, and derive measures for the process improvement. The agenda for this presentation can be seen here. First, I would like to motivate for our research. Then, the underlying research method is issued. The new artifact designed is presented thereafter. As we already deal with chatbots based on this, some insights are given about the DSL constructed. The case study is presented then, and the evaluation of simple dialogues is issued. Limitations and further research needs are presented finally. At last year's BMSD session, we have spoken about a kind of knowledge management model with which we intend to focus on the symbiosis of human and artificial knowledge carriers. Here, we respect humans as knowledge carriers, AI-based systems as knowledge carriers, and we further respect their collaboration to be important. These need to be managed in different organizational levels, procedural ranges, personal and educative ranges, for instance. This year's paper will focus on the fourth activity called Identification of Knowledge by visualizing AI-based knowledge. Further, we focus on the sixth activity called Preparation of Knowledge by modifying AI-based knowledge. In addition, we focus on the ninth activity called Cleaning Up of Knowledge by deleting the chatbot's knowledge. Hence, this year's presentation will focus on attempting how to manage intelligent systems with the aid of a domain-specific language. Here, sub-research questions have been: first, how can an adequate foundation be identified systematically with which we are able to construct intelligent chatbots? Second, how can domain-specific knowledge be integrated with AI-based systems? As we intend to manage knowledge of these kinds of systems, we have to deal with non-transparent knowledge transfers. Only if these are visualized, we will be able to control and modify them. You see, we have to consider quite a lot of requirements for the construction of an appropriate system and knowledge management attempt. Hence, let's face a methodology which will be helpful for this. From our perspective, that's the design science research methodology from Preffers et al. Here, objectives are rather requirements for a solution are specified before the artifact is designed. In our case, the artifact refers to a domain-specific language and its visualization, which is capable to be processed by chatbots directly. This artifact will be demonstrated in a case study and then evaluated. Finally, results are communicated. So let's face the requirements first. First, we were required to identify core systems, tools, libraries, and products that can be used for implementing the chatbot. Second, different kinds of knowledge sources need to be considered at the process. For instance, here we have customer relation management systems, product information management systems, and so on. Third, as we want the human to deal with this in a drag and drop manner, we need a visualization of this. Fourth, as we want the intelligent systems to process on this, we need one common technical level for human as well as machines. As we were not sure how to deal with knowledge on a chatbot level best, we have decided to realize a morphological analysis. Here, the research problem is operationalized by numerous dimensions and different options for each dimension. As these are all put in one morphological box, we were able to face numerous experts by these options and gather the widest acceptance. This was defined to be our optimal solution, the so-called best configuration. Finally, we have applied this solution for the chatbot construction. So, how does the design of a domain-specific language and its foundation finally look like? Let's face the identification of an appropriate foundation first. Here, you can see the morphological box we have created. Row-wise, you can see an extract of about 45 dimensions of our research problem. Column-wise, and highlighted in white, you can see an extract of about 7 different kinds of scales per dimension. The green columns title the dimension and show a guiding question. This shall simplify the evaluation of scales provided. With the instrument presented here, we have surveyed 12 experts for identifying the best configuration. After the survey, we have applied the best configuration and an analysis has been carried out. Here we have considered about 22 relevant tools. While you can find the details in the paper, let's face the results at the presentation only. From 5 CRM tools, we have identified HubSpot to be an adequate foundation for integrating a CRM tool. From 9 PIM tools, PIMCore is an attractive opportunity for integrating chatbots with PIM tools. Confluence has been selected from 3 knowledge management tools. TensorFlow has been selected from 5 AI tools. Now let's face the domain-specific language. We came up with numerous DSL files. One example issuing the dialogues can be seen at the left. Here we can recognize the sequence of dialogues elements. For instance, the chatbot first recognizes the customer's intent to greet in dialogue. Then the chatbot utters the greeting and asks how it can help. Gathering the customer's answers, the intent recognition needs to recognize the customer's request. In our example, this refers to the price request of a certain bag. Hence, the chatbot is asked to realize this search request and utter the price information. Along this dialogue sequence, on the right, you can see different kinds of grammar-based definition. For instance, we need actions to specify things the chatbot can do or say. Aliases specify alternative titles for the same object. These can be used as synonyms during the conversation. The intents represent what the customer wants to do. At least, that is what the chatbot's neural net system thinks the customer does. Responses represent hard-coded values or messages the chatbot can respond with. Please further remark the slots that are a kind of variable at the dialogue. It stores information the chatbot needs to track. While we have come up with a generator that creates DSL files as specified, this is a machine interpretable modeling level. Since we wanted the human to be able to read this kind of model, to modify it and control the chatbot by interacting with this, we came up with a visualization approach. The visualization approach you can see here. First, process views specify the system's behavior and focus on dialogue sequences. Second, activity views specify the knowledge use and generation from perspective of the dialogue partners. Third, knowledge overviews specify a breaking down of human-readable objects to machine-readable entities. Let's come to an example. Here you can see the knowledge overviews of three kinds of systems, which have been generated automatically from the chatbot system. First, the chatbot. On the top left, you see aliases with which the chatbot can deal with. Further, we have a selection of different options to greet, say goodbye, or utter greetings. Second, the CRM system. On the bottom left, you can see a visualization of customer-specific information. For instance, the CRM system provides the current offer of a certain customer. Third, the PIM system. On the bottom right, you can see knowledge that is attached to a certain product. In our case, this refers to the product called bag. Its price is 1,000 euros and it's categorized as accessoire. Through the adding of further objects or removing of the one or other object, the chatbot knowledge base is modified and we can manage it. This will affect the chatbot's conversation. Let's come back to the dialogue DSL file, which we saw before. You still remember the dialogue sequence? The corresponding visualization can be found at the process view. Here, we easily can see what is said by whom. By removing the one or other dialogue stream, the chatbot's behavior and dialogue can be modified by human model constructor. Facing the chatbot's behavior, it can be managed by the human model constructor. Further, human knowledge carriers can be guided by this. Let's face some of the corresponding activity views. On the top left, we can see the customer arriving at the chat. The chatbot's neural intent recognition needs to recognize the customer's intent. The chatbot's neural action identification then selects one of many responses and posts this at the chat. In our case, this response refers to the greeting of "Hey." As a second example, let's face the bottom right activity. Here, we see the interplay of three kinds of systems. Meanwhile, during the whole conversation, the chatbot has recognized the customer's product request. Because of this, the current price information is gathered from the PIM system. Finally, this price information is weighted by the current offer coming from the CRM system. Again, the chatbot's neural intent recognition and action identification are activated and the chatbot presents its answer at the chat. So the customer receives the desired information. But how can the knowledge management model be applied at live settings? Imagine an intelligent chatbot continuously answering live on websites. As often as requested, knowledge is extracted from different kinds of information systems. At the process model presented, on the very left, you can see example systems such as CRM and PIM systems. The transfer is realized with the aid of the base module. It generates the domain-specific language files we just saw before. Thereafter, an algorithmic labeling is realized by a human data scientist. So, the training is prepared. Let's face the chatbot system first. The DSL files are considered for training and testing routines. Once the training procedure has finalized, the chatbot is ready for perceiving customer input. As an example, you can imagine a chatbot being faced by a text message on websites. For any input, text, or character typed by the customer, the neural language process pipeline is activated. Here, the intent and the entities are recognized by neural networks. Then, neural networks consider the outcome activation for predicting the best action to perform. Afterwards, neural networks generate the best response for being presented at the website. A last task realizes the communication of action, which means presenting dialogue information on the website. Via the feedback loop from one XOR to the previous XOR, the loop for continuous neural activation is closed. At any time point during the continuous chatbot activity, The transformation module imports the domain-specific language files and prepares the model visualization we just saw before. Here, the human can carry out any kind of model modification in order to manage knowledge of intelligent systems. When finalized, the model modification models are exported so that these new versions are part of the continuous chatbot activity loop we have issued before. The whole process is terminated in the case of chatbot is not required anymore. So much about the case. Let's focus on the evaluation. We have no hard performance indicator information about the chatbot yet. So far, we can verify if requirements have been met. First, an adequate foundation has been met as the set of core systems, tools, libraries, and products has been analyzed in regard with their attractiveness for implementing the chatbot. The second requirement can be met because different kinds of knowledge sources have been considered at the process. Third requirement can be met by the modeling language constructed. It visualizes relevant information of intelligent systems. Fourth, the requirement of a common technical level for human as well as machines can be met, as DSL files have been constructed on which intelligent systems and humans can process. Let's face the conclusion. How have research questions been answered? First, the research question, how can an adequate foundation of the construction of intelligent chatbots be identified systematically, can be answered by the creation of a morphological box operationalizing the research problem. As it has been identified, best configuration empirically by a survey, and best performing systems have been selected because of an analysis, an adequate foundation has been identified. Second, the research question, how can domain-specific knowledge be integrated with AI-based systems, can be answered by the creation of a file-based DSL format. The DSL adequate modeling language visualizes this. Hence, the final research question can be answered as follows. Through the interactive interplay of DSL files and its modeling language, intelligent systems can be managed on a graphical level. Since independent AI approaches operate on the DSL level, the domain-specific language serves as a common level for integrating intelligent systems here. Although we are already realizing these dialogues, in the paper we only can speak about a theoretical validation and a laboratory test. We focus on simple dialogues and we have analyzed a limited set of 22 tools only. Hence, onboarding research should expand the toolbase for analysis and consider more complex dialogues. As a next step in our research, current dialogue data needs to be analyzed by key performance indicators so that we can evaluate the functioning on the basis of hard facts. In our opinion, future research must face the non-isolated, non-laboratory setting so that findings can be transferred to reality. So, we are looking forward to future research steps on this, and we thank you for your attention.